60 miles west of Atlanta sits Harrelson County, Georgia.
Thank you, honey.
You have a good day.
Here, lunch is served with the side of disbelief.
Do you believe in the results and what happened here in Georgia?
No. Really don't.
Who do you think won in November?
I honestly think Trump did.
Who do you think won the election in your viewpoint?
Trump? I think Trump did.
For some shell-shock supporters of the president, it's impossible to think about the upcoming January Senate runoffs with a continued deluge of misinformation from President Trump and others.
You voted in November. How are you feeling about the runoffs?
I really don't know. I don't know if it's going to change anything or not. It may not.
Why do you say that?
I mean, with all the voter fraud and all the stuff they're talking about, so I don't know 100%, you know, what's going on or how they count the votes or whatever. So, you know, it's confusing, but, you know, trust in anything anymore.
That is the Republican nightmare in the upcoming Senate runoffs, because here, the Republican who could hold the most sway is Trump. In Harrelson County, the president increases support by about 3,000 votes from 4 years ago, a trend in deep red counties. Donald Trump not only won these counties in November, he did so by roughly 276,000 more votes than in 2016. Republicans need that enthusiastic GOP base in places like Harrelson to vote for incumbent Republican Senators Kelly Loeffler and David Perdue in the January 5th runoffs.
We're going to win Georgia.
But there's a complication. The president keeps saying this.
They know it was a fixed election. It was a rigged election. They know it, and I appreciate their support.
That baseless claim puts the incumbent senators on the ballot in a political pickle. Listen to David Perdue try to square that circle.
Look, President Trump's very frustrated. I'm very frustrated. We're going to do everything we possibly can to make sure that whatever anomalies are uncovered in November don't happen in January. But this is illogical for any Republican to think that, oh, I'm just going to sit down and not vote and hand, as you say, the keys over to the Democrats.
It has caused me concern.
Republican Buzz Brockway is a former Georgia state representative. He says Republicans are already telling him they will not vote in January.
I've had dozens of people tell me that, the people that I knew.
They're just not going to show up.
Mm-hmm. I do my best to try to talk them out of it, but the internet spreads things like wildfire.
What happens if the president keeps tweeting and talking about a rigged election?
That hurts. That absolutely hurts, because he has a very passionate group of followers who, frankly, are more committed to him than they are to the Republican Party. If he were to continue with that message, that would be very hurtful to the Republican Party and to Loeffler and Perdue.
Not everyone in Harrelson County believes Trump's mixed message hurts. Andy Gunther, active in the local Republican Party, says the more outraged Trump is at the rally, the higher the enthusiasm for the senators.
It's going to boost the electorate to come out stronger, I believe.
And why stronger?
It's defiance. It's, you know, we're not going to take this stuff sitting down. We're going to come back out. We're going to vote. We're going to show that we care.
Hyung Law, CNN, Harrelson County, Georgia.